Hey guys and girls, I am in South Dakota, and what you're seeing behind me is beautiful Owyhee Lake, and it's an incredible lake. I got to fish it today. I'm up here with, I'm telling you, I'm out here in kind of the bushes, and the light is not good. I'm backlit, I know that, but I'm gonna get up here because I'm down on my knees, and that wasn't too good at all. But I'm up here with my buddy Johnny Morse, founder of Bass Pro Shop. As Johnny puts it, I run a little bait shop in Springfield, Missouri. But I'm up here with Johnny. We're up here with Governor Kristi Noem from South Dakota for a walleye event today, and we had a great time out there. We walleye fished this morning, and you know, we've had some of our other friends up here and having a great time. It was just a tremendous time out there. And we had some contests going. It was kind of a little tournament. And we kind of think it kind of came in a draw between Johnny Morris's boat and our boat. And we were fishing for walleye, and we just had a great time. And an amazing thing happened to me out here today. I had put a little deal up on Facebook this morning of a patriotic America ice chest that Johnny gave all of the people that are participating in this event. And he had them in our room. It's got a little plaque on there that presented to Jimmy Houston, a patriotic American ice chest. It's just an incredibly great chest. I'm sure you can get them at Bass Pro Shop. But and it was filled with goodies. It's just an ice chest full of great stuff. So it's just an amazing gift that Johnny gave all the participants. And so I took a picture of that this morning, stuck it up on Facebook. And we're out there fishing, and my cousin, who lives in Seattle, Washington, David Houston, David said, "Are you in South Dakota?" And I sent him a note back, and texted me while we was out fishing. I sent him a note back, and I said, "Yeah, I'm on Lake Owyhee with Governor Kristi Noem and my buddy Johnny Morris and some friends of ours." And he said, I can't believe that." And when I got back to the boat dock, we came in this afternoon. David and his wife Denise were there, and so I got to hug him and see him a little while. I don't get to see him very often. He's got one of my Ranger boats, one of my older Ranger boats that he bought from me, and he's got the Ranger. He's got his camper trailer. He's retired, and so they're going to spend 2 or 3 weeks. They just got here, but that just shows you what a small world it is. You know, I live in Oklahoma. David lives in Seattle. Here we are in South Dakota on beautiful Owyhee Lake. This is an incredibly great lake. I mean, it's just super, and an incredibly beautiful spot we're at right here. I don't know if y'all look around and see, you know, what all's around me. It's just amazing. Look back through there, and I know that the sun's bad and everything, but if you look around, we turn around this way, you see our cabins back behind us. I wanted to get the lake back behind us, but you see our cabins back there behind us. And you get the sunlight, which is correct right in here when we're right with the sunlight and filming and everything, this is good. But that lake back behind us is just spectacular. And now they have a lot of rattlesnakes down here. We was out on a golf course. We were shooting some on the shooting range this afternoon, having a great time. And the golf course got signs already, beware of rattlesnakes. Watch out for the rattlesnakes. They have prairie rattlesnakes up here, which are not very big. I mean, they're a couple, you know, 12, 14, 16, 18 inches long, 24 inches long, a couple foot. They're not very big, but they're deadly poisonous. My uncle up in Kansas got bit by one, spent 6 weeks in the hospital. That's how dangerous they are. So they are very dangerous. They are very dangerous. I'm going to set this thing back down a little bit right there while I'm talking. But, and I know that we're tilted and everything. You know, this is not a great video production, but I just wanted to visit with you a little bit and share what an amazing story that was. And so my cousin, he said, is Governor Noem, is she here? And I said, she's still out fishing. And about that time, she came up the hill, and she came over and gave my cousin a hug and met him and his wife. Johnny came up and met him. And I'm going to tell you, it was a thrill for them to get to meet the governor. It's a thrill for me to get to meet the governor. I think a thrill for Johnny also. She's one of the greatest governors in the United States. Maybe president of the United States someday. So it's just absolutely amazing. I want to thank Kristi Noem for inviting Johnny up here, and Johnny in turn for inviting me to come up here with him. It's been a very special trip with a very special friend, and it just means so much to me. We've been working with Bass Pro Shop ever since that very first store started over there in Springfield, and that's almost 50 years ago now, working with them with Tracker Boats. Obviously, they own Ranger Boats now, and so it's been a great, great relationship and a great friendship with Johnny and Jeannie and the entire family, JP, Luke, the whole family. You know, it's just been amazing. And it's just, it'll probably continue as long as Johnny and I are out there and able to go. We'll keep promoting bass fishing and having a great time. I also wanted to give you a little update on Chris, because it's been a week since I've talked about her here on on our social media, our Facebook and our YouTube. And by the way, thank you so much. We went over 600,000 on Facebook this week. That's right, 600,000 people on Facebook. So if all of y'all will share somebody, we can hit a million sometimes, you know, in the not too distant future. Over 106,000 or 107,000, I think, I'm not sure which, on our Jimmy Houston Outdoors YouTube channel. So share with everybody and let's get those numbers up. And I think about 17,000 on our Catch of the Day channel, which we post a video every single morning. But this week has been a slow week, progressive-wise, with Chris. She's having a lot of trouble with her speech. She's gaining a lot of strength in her legs. But her speech, she's having an awful lot of problems with. And sometimes it's so good, it's amazing. I mean, sometimes she just talks to me like I'm talking to y'all and you can understand every word. And then other times, when she gets really tired, she has a real hard time concentrating. And, you know, we show her pictures and try to get her to say full sentences. And she has a speech therapist come, you know, for a couple hours a week, maybe there in home. Home rehab, but she'll be starting the rehab in Tulsa this next week. She will be getting to stay with me at the ranch for another week. I say getting, that's what I'm thinking. She may not be thinking that, but she's going to get to stay there with me another week. It's going to be a week from Monday before Sherry and Jack Stairlift gets put in their house, and she'll be able to go over there and stay with them a while. But she will be she'll be staying with me. She'll be staying with me for another week, and which is just a blessing, a very big blessing, even though she's a lot of work, I gotta admit, but it's a labor of love because I love her so much. And she's just doing great. She's getting stronger, and it won't be long until she's walking. I'm telling you, she's moving her right leg, which is her bad leg, more than ever now. And I believe that once she gets in rehab 3 days a week in Tulsa at Kaiser Rehab Center up at the Hillcrest Hospital, I think that they will have her walking in some way, shape, fashion, or form. And I told her the other day, I said, honey, won't you be glad when you can get up in the middle of the night and go to the bathroom by yourself? And I just think about that. Well, how simple a deal that is for all the rest of us. And yet she can't do it. And she said, oh man, it sure will. It'll be great. I said, well, it'll be great for me too, by the way. But it will be great when she can do that. That will be a major, major victory, a major thing that we're looking at. It'll be fantastic. And but she'll be going to that rehab center, so I think she'll be gaining quite a bit throughout the next couple, 2 or 3 weeks over there. I don't know how long she'll be at that rehab center. I know that they, the doctor, Dr. Craven, our lady doctor over there, has only given her a disability pass, disability handicap parking pass for 6 months. So she doesn't plan on her being handicapped or disabled for very long. And I'm sure her speech is going to get a lot better. They're going to work with her 3 hours a day, 3 days a week. We will be taking her up there and back and forth, and she'll probably be coming down spending the weekends with me at the ranch with some of the other kids and grandkids, and it's going to be great. But keep in mind, God is still healing Chris. God is still doing what God does. He's healing Chris, and he's doing his healing work. It takes time, it takes patience, it takes effort, and we're putting in all of the bud. God has equipped me. God has equipped Chris. God has equipped Sherry and Jack and all of our family to fight this battle we're fighting, to beat this stroke, to beat this brain aneurysm, and we're going to do it. And I appreciate the prayers. I appreciate everything that y'all have done. Y'all have been just like the greatest friends in the world. I mean, there's just been so many people praying, so many people asking God, shaking the gates of heaven, asking God to heal Chris, and I love you so much for it. I mean, I'm just overwhelmed. I'm still just blown away by the love you have for my beautiful wife. And she looks beautiful. I tell her every day how pretty she is. I tell her how now. I give her kisses. I hug her. I love her so much. It's amazing, difficult struggle we're going through. But let me tell you, when you belong to God, when you have the Holy Spirit down inside of you, God will equip you to fight the toughest battles that you had to fight in your life. And when they come, and they'll happen to everybody, that's just life, that's the devil controlling this world, when they come, you'll be ready and you'll fight those battles. And God will grab you and pick you up. And every time you stumble and fall and trip, God will grab you and pick you up. Every time you have problems and lose your patience and lose your cool, God will restore you. He'll build your faith up. And Chris is going to be healed. God is healing Chris. She's going to be walking. I'm still going to say before the end of June. And it's still not there yet. This is only June 12th. Sherry had a birthday yesterday, 39 years old. Happy birthday again to my beautiful daughter, Sherry. Y'all have a great one out there. And remember, guys and girls, I sure do love you. Hey, we'll see you We'll see you tomorrow afternoon, Sunday afternoon chat. Don't know what we'll talk about, but it'll sure be fun and interesting. Later, guys. I love you.